Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to Miller Monday, guys. And it is always Miller time on Miller Monday. I keep forgetting this. It's the only thing I always forget on Miller Monday. Is the Miller time. This says it's Miller time. There we go. There. So we know what we're drinking on. It's Miller Monday. It's been a great day. Welcome. I hope everybody's had an amazing day. I've had an amazing day. So, yeah, we're going to start off with shots because what else is there to do on a Miller Monday? And we're going to be taking shots of our Pinnacle Whipped Chocolate, okay? So, as I am going to contradict myself in a minute. Cheers to everyone who did sub between the last live video and this one. That being on Finish on Friday, which we actually ended up having something to finish on Finish on Friday due to a fun night before. And then a great weekend, guys. So cheers to everyone who did sub, who did become part of the family, or just tuned in and watched. Y'all are amazing. Cheers. What's good? I don't know why I put that back up. There. So good. It's got a great spiciness to it, but it ends with a really good, like, marshmallowy chocolate taste. It's just A1. Alright, so, it's Miller Lite. What else would we do on a Miller Monday if we didn't have Miller Lite? Tis Miller time does not always mean Miller Lite, though, and I've been thinking about kind of changing that up, you know? There's Miller High Life, there's Miller 64, there's Miller Lite, there's Genuine Giraffe. There's a bunch of different Millers out there, and I think, I'm about positive, there's at least four different ones. So every month, I think we'll do a Miller Monday, and every Monday will be a different Miller. So I think that'd be fun, mostly because I love all Miller Lite, or Millers in general. There's a bunch of them out there, I think, other than just four. Yeah, you got Miller. Oh, there's a bunch. Okay, so you got Miller Lite, Miller High Life, Miller Genuine Draft, and Miller 64. So yeah, you got. So yeah, you got four of them. I got a lot. That's look at Miller Fortune. And then they got Miller High Life Beer Light. So, a light Miller High Life. I feel like a light Miller High Life would be the exact same as Miller Lite. We're going to do a comparison review on that because it makes no sense. Why have Miller Lite, and then, which is a light version of Miller, and then have Miller High Life, then you make Miller High Life Light. I feel like this is Miller Lite with a whole lot of extra words in it. Beer's a little frothy. My hand's a little shaky. I've been weed eating all day. Gents, let me tell you what. Lawn care is not my favorite thing. By no means. I actually despise lawn care. But I love the outcome. Whenever the grass is mowed and it looks good, I love it. Great transition. Well, as all you guys know, Pretty Lady loves plants, right? So, with that income, her love for plants, we let our weeds and everything else like that grow a little taller. That way the bees have something to eat on, right? The normal stuff. Well, today I was going to mow. Well, I go outside, or yesterday I was actually going to mow. So I go outside yesterday, and I go to start the mower, and it won't start. So I pull my truck over, and I try to jump start the mower. Then the mower kind of runs, but doesn't necessarily like run on its own. So I was like, okay, I need a battery. So I go to Walmart today and I buy a new battery. I was like, might as well get some oil, and I bought some new gas on the way back. So new battery, new oil, new gas, right? So I drained the old gas out, I drained the carb, drained the fuel line. I put in the new gas, I drained the oil, I put in new oil, and then I put in the new battery. It then started on its own, but would not stay running. Okay, next thing, my next step was fuel filter. So I go back underneath, pull the panels back off, I find the fuel filter, I pull the fuel filter, it's a little rough. So I go to Tractor Supply, I buy me a new filter, come back home, I put the filter in. It's running better, but it still would not stay running. I was able to at least drive it a little bit this time. So with that being said, I was trying to like manipulate it around. I was confused. I was trying to like not get aggravated with it. Well, I drive it up around like not even like 10 foot and it would shut off. And then I'm just trying to fight this thing to get it back over to where I usually leave it at. Well, I call my buddy Ray as always. Anytime I have any type of mechanical issue, if I can't figure it out, I call him. Well, he thinks the stator went bad. Just from what I'm explaining to him and told him everything that I replaced. So he thinks the stator went bad. Which kind of helps control the fuel go into the engine, from what I understand. Well, however, as I was tinkering with this mower trying to get it back, somebody that I used to work with a long time ago that is still friends with my mom, and I still see him around all over the place, and we still chat every time we see each other, he so happened to be riding by. Well, he stopped in, he's like, "What you up to?" And I hung up with Ray and I started talking to him. I was explaining to him everything that was going on with the mower. And he come over and he walked over to the mower and he looked at it. He showed me a few other things that I could take apart and drain. So it's an electrical on the bottom of the carb. So you drop that electrical down, half inch wrench, you take off the little valve at the bottom and you let it drain out a little bit. He said usually sometimes over the winter you end up with some water down in there and you let it drain out. Okay. Easy. Got it. I'll drain it out. So we drain it down a little bit, start it up. It kind of does the same thing. It'll pitter-patter and then it'll shut back off. And he watched it do it a few times. He tried a few other tricks to see what we calls it. Try running it without certain things hooked up. Just troubleshooting. Well, pretty much we've got it boiled down to either new carb, carb rebuild, or stator. So one of the three things are my options. But he was nice enough. He offered to mow the yard. Paid him, obviously. So I didn't mow my yard today. I had somebody else mowed. But honestly, if I start looking into parts and stuff and it doesn't seem like it's worth fixing, I may just go and start paying somebody to mow my yard. Mostly because it saves me time because I don't really have a lot of time anyway. And some people do it to make extra money or it's their actual job to do that. So might as well help them out. Yeah, that's how I look at it. And it wasn't terrible either, and the job, he done an amazing job. I done all the weed eating. I don't mind doing stuff that I'm able to do. If I'd had my mower, I would have mowed today. But I didn't, and I couldn't even get my push mower to start. It wouldn't do anything, so I was just kind of flustered with everything. Weed eated around the house, weed eated the trees and all that other fun stuff, got everything taped up for him. And then he mowed the yard for us, and I'm completely grateful for it. My yard was looking like a jungle, guys. A complete thing. Like almost, well, I don't want to say knee high. It wasn't knee high to like me, but it might have been like knee high to Ash. Whenever they're outside, but if pretty lady was to walk through it, she would probably be like neck deep in that stuff. But it's okay. Taking care of him now. Looks amazing. Pretty lady spent a lot of time outside today getting in front of the house all stiffed up as usual for the springtime. Plants, flowers, gnome garden, all that other fairy garden stuff that she's got out set up. And then I got to relax a little bit while the weed eater was charging. I use a Hart brand weed eater. It takes a 40-volt battery. I love that thing. I can usually get majority of all my weed eating done with it. Unless, like, I haven't weed eaten in a long time, like, throughout the whole winter. And it'll take a little bit, like two charges to do it. But I'm also going to be buying leaf blower and stuff soon too, and it's going to take the same battery, so I'll get another battery also, so I won't ever have to worry about one dying. I'll just switch out batteries and keep rolling. So that was was my day. Really fun. Me and Pretty Lady hung out a little bit. She got off at 1. I love how our Mondays and Tuesdays work, because Monday, I kind of have my morning to sleep in, you know, a little bit. That's really all I need. It's like one day a week where I'm able to sleep in a little bit and kind of relax. And then we spend the evening together, or I'll play video games or something usually. And then Tuesday's our day. Usually, tomorrow we're going to go shopping and do some stuff. I think we're going to be heading out to Moonjoy Meadery again tomorrow. She wants to go try their new peach mead. So, Daniel, if you're watching, we'll be there tomorrow probably. More than likely, we'll be there tomorrow. We didn't come in today because tomorrow is supposed to be rainy and dreary, so we decided to do all of our yard care and yard work today instead of tomorrow. So, on that, we ended up doing all that, so now we're going to push all of our plans for today to tomorrow. So, tomorrow we're going to go Easter shopping, spring shopping. We got to buy some gifts for some people. And then we're going to go out to some antique shops out in the Lenore area. And then we're going to be going to get some mead and doing some stuff, you know. So it's going to be really fun, eventful day tomorrow. Driving around as usual. Don't mind it. But it's been a really good week, I think. Vacation's getting closer and closer. Couldn't be more excited about it. Probably one of the longest trips that we've taken together. Not in like length of time, but length and distance. We're going to be driving all the way through up to Virginia, and then we're going to go from Virginia, then we're going to go to Kentucky. Depending on how things go, we may not come back down through there, but we'll probably more than likely go through there. And then depending, we'll probably come back down through and then back up and all that stuff. So we'll see how it all pans out and plays out, but definitely going to be one of the furthest drives. Because we go to Gatlinburg and Pigeon Forge, which is only like a 4-hour drive from my house to there. Going to Kentucky is going to be over 5 to 6 hours. So it's going to be fun. I think it's going to be a really fun drive and freight drive. Because I like to take a long ways and scenic ways. So we'll see what she wants. But it's going to be fun. No doubt. I'm going to turn the temperature down up in my mini fridge. It's starting to ice over the beers. Oh, another bump. Speaking of which, of yard work and stuff, if you litter and you throw stuff out the window into other people's yards, you have to be like on the low side of low, because like people have to clean that up. Me, myself, like I live close to the end of a main road, or on the main road, like right off the main road. So my ditch is just always littered with people's trash. So we always have to pick it up. Or there's a lot of times where I don't see it in the grass. Like today, there was a half-busted bottle of glass, a glass bottle on the ground. I didn't see it until I had hit it with my weed eater and it sliced it again. And this little tiny shards from it, when it broke, went into like sporadic spots in the side of my knee and my shin. So, if you're littering, you are like on the low and not even like people that have to like clean it up, animals and everything else like that, it's not good. Not good for the animals and the environment. You gotta stay clean. It's easy, you know. Your car, if you're littering, I guarantee your car is already a mess. So, throw it in your floorboard. Throw it in your floorboard. Because you don't know how to, at that point, I don't think you know how to clean up, so you're just throwing it outside for somebody else's problem, so you just probably clutter your own car up, because then it's not your problem anymore, it's just there. So yeah, just kind of help everybody else out. Yeah. That's how I look at it. Maybe that's a bad way to look at it. Oh, man. Been a long day, though. What time? 4th. 9 p.m. and 9 p.m. We're gonna catch 9. Hopefully. We'll be right back. whatever, though. If we do go on to the side of paying somebody to mow for us, if anybody out there is looking for a mower that knows how to fix it. Oh, so close, so, so close. This is like the best attention thing ever. A lot of people like fidget spinners and stuff like that. And I used to use fidget spinners and fidget toys back when they first came out. But granted, fidget spinners are quieter. They're not like banging all around all the time. I like the tactile. It's more like interactive. And then again, some of those fidget spinners, man, they got all their click clicks. And I don't think I've ever seen many that was like not like overly drastic, except for the ones that just spin. All the other ones have a bunch of doodads on them. Also, don't remember if I told you guys, but we broke the bottle cap shooter. However, pretty lady bought two of them that day, and she gave me the other one. So I'm gonna be saving this one in the box until I go on a like an adventure or something like that with the group, and then I'll take it with me. Pull the lever, open bottle, and then pull the trigger. Wow. Love it. Great. Good. Friday was a really good stream, though. Loved it. Had a great time. The reviews this weekend were really, really great. If you did not catch yesterday's review or upload, you gotta go check it out. We toured the Moonjoy Meadery a few weeks ago back, and I finally was able to get the video to work properly for me after stitching it together. So go check that out. A little bit long, but well worth the video. Other than that, the review on Saturday was good. The Fireball and Miller Lite was a little rough around the edges. It's not going to be made again. But we tried it, so you guys get it. Which I don't want anybody to think that. So. The other thing we're going to probably do some soon is I'm probably going to make a poll on the channel where you guys will be able to see it on the community tab. It'll be a place where everybody can vote. I'm probably going to pick like 4 or 5 drinks, you know, something light. And then I'll probably pick like 4 or 5 pairs of drinks. And then, so like one will be a beer versus a beer, another one, so on, so on, so on, right? And then it'll be people's favorites against others' favorites, and then I will compare them to tell you which one is better, whether it be a mixed drink, a beer, 2 bottles of something, you know. Within reason, I'm not going to go out and spend $100 a bottle and spend $200 on a video, but we'll definitely do something cool with it, and I'll leave it up to you guys to vote on what we will do. Whether it'll just be like whiskey versus whiskey or rum, something like that. So I think it's gonna be really fun, a good competition thing, and it'll be a good time for everybody that wants to like vote to be able to vote and be a part of the channel in that way. A lot of people either don't know how to comment, don't comment, but still want their opinions heard at the same time. That's why the like button and dislike button is there. So this one's gonna be a good for the vote of everybody to see like what we could like put up against each other, I think. So it'll be fun. I'm interested in it. We did the versus video a few weeks back, and it turned out pretty good. So nailed it. My fingers will not stop itching. We are truth. Found a penny earlier, and now my finger won't stop itching. Does that mean I'm gonna get more money? My granny And a lot of like older people always told me like whenever your hand itches, like you're gonna be getting some money. And then like when your ears burn, somebody's talking about you. Or like when you can't sleep at night, that means somebody else is dreaming about you or something. It's a bunch of weird stuff. I don't know. But nonetheless, cheers. Perfect.
Oh.
So, what we're gonna be jerking on is Japanese whiskey. Hatozaki. Hatozaki. It is from the Hatozaki Lighthouse, the oldest stone lighthouse in Japan. It has been a guide for sailors navigating the turbulent waters before the port of Akashi ever since 1620. It is a symbol of dependability, openness to the wider world, and trade, which enables the exchange of goods and ideas. We chose this lighthouse, which stands so close to our distillery, as the perfect icon to represent their whiskey. Product of Japan. Produced and bottled by Kaikyo Distillery? Kyo? Akashi Saki Brewery LTD. 40% alcohol, 80 proof. They have a website, www.hatozaki.whiskey.com. Without coloring or chilled filtration. The U.S. importer is through Niche W. and S. / Cedar Knolls, New Jersey. OurNiche.com. Really good. I love it. Like, heck, we can even compare something like this to, like, any other, like, another Japanese whiskey. There's only two affordable ones that I could say, and that's this Hatozaki and the Suntory. And now, they're both really, really good. Suntory is, my cousin's favorite over this one. I like this one. I kind of feel like they're kind of similar. But we could definitely do comparison videos through those and maybe get like a different one. But Japanese whiskeys, true Japanese whiskey, is not cheap. I think the next available bottle at my liquor store is $100, and then the one above that's like $160. So it drastically gets higher and higher as you go on. But Japanese whiskey is one of those things where it's really, it's in high demand because a lot of people really want it. Where from the import side of drinks and stuff, but for me at least, I've only noticed it here recently to get a lot bigger in fame as far as people wanting to buy it and drink it. But I asked my liquor store, and he said that it's been a thing for a long time. People just, it's just really hard to get and keep it in. So whenever it's in and they're able to keep it in stock, it seems like more people are buying it because they have it, or more people will buy it out. And then you'll come in and one day they'll have like 3 cases, and you'll come in the next day, and they'll only have like 2 or 3 bottles left. So, man, I can't stop yelling at them. Ooh, spicy. And I do love how they don't do the chill filter. I like the taste of it. It's a lot smoother, I think. Has more burn to it. Now, this one is a lot lighter than the Suntory. I think the Suntory is just a dead bit darker. And the bottle difference is really neat, too. The only thing I don't like about the Suntory bottle is that the Suntory, the Japanese whiskey bottle, is not straight on the bottom. So, the Suntory bottle, you can see it there waddling. See, it doesn't. It doesn't sit still like this one does. This one's flat on the bottom. This one's got like a corner that's off. But it's also really, really good, and I love it. This one was in 1923. This one was in 1917, I think it was. 1817. Yeah. So 1917, so this one's got a lot longer heritage than this one does. Only by 6 years, though. So only a 6 years difference. This one's from the House of Suntory Whiskey, Taki. Also 40%, though. So really, really good. Worth buying. And I think the other really interesting detail that Suntory uses that they didn't use on the Harazaki was that on the Harazaki they have a plastic film around the top here. It's plastic like any other bottle would be. Now, on the Suntory, they used a cloth top and an entire cloth casing, and then you would peel that off, and then that's what you get. So, I think it's just more of an attention to detail type thing that they put into it. And the bottle itself is kind of like, got a lot of curvature to it. It's just really different, really weird. But on the Suntory, though, I also got a lot of, like, scotchier vibes off of it. It was more roasted, more... Turn music down slightly. I think the Suntory is more scotchy. I think, in general, because it's got a more of a smokier essence, kind of like a fire smell. Actually, yeah, I guess, in my opinion. I like the Harazaki a little bit more. Kenny, he likes the Suntory more. So, it's just preference, but I think they both have a lot of similarities in them. But this one's definitely a lot lighter, but a lot heavier in taste. And I think that's why. And it has a spicier taste to it, more like a bourbon barrel taste. Today was also a very stressful day anyway, because today is the first day that I have not had a single soda all day. At all. I have not had a single soda all day. I'm quitting sodas, sugar drinks, and stuff like that. Unless it's for the live stream, something like that, where you guys want me to mix something up or anything like that. Then, yeah, more the merrier. We're gonna do that later, you know? If we're mixing Dr. Pepper and a rum, or a Coke and a Captain Morgan, you know, something like that, we're going to mix. We're going to do that kind of stuff. But overall, as a daily drink or a normal drink, I'm going to be cutting sodas that have sugar in them. Even my mixed drinks might be zero sugar, you know, just because I just want, needlessly, the caffeine's there, but I need to kick the sugars and a lot of the salts. So that's going to be along the lines of what I'm working with. Try to shed a few pounds, you know. Not happy necessarily with my weight. Not mad at it. It doesn't necessarily bother me that much. But I just don't want it to get out of hand to where I let myself go and it's unfixable, you know. Right now it's easy, you know, I just change up my diet and just drop some weight, you know, easy. Start doing some cardio, some calisthenics, you know, and take care of myself other than, and be, I'm not really stressed by nothing, but try to manage my time a little bit better and do some more things other than eat, sleep, stream, make videos, and work. So, we're going to try to kind of work some more stuff in there. Me and Pretty Lady's been getting out more now that we're metal detecting and stuff. It's been so fun finding things. And if you've never metal detected or you're needing to pick up a hobby, I'm telling you, metal detecting is a thing. When it gets warmer out and about, I definitely want to get into the thing that Kenny was talking about last year with some magnet fishing and stuff like that. I've already started bass fishing this year. The fall time, I want to get into some hunting and everything else like that. So I got a full plate this year to try doing new things. Hey, buddy. How's it going, man? How you doing? Well, my friends from the Snack Network. How y'all doing? Go away. Cheers. I do assume it is David. I think usually David's the one that kind of jumps in here and says hello. They've been doing a lot of things over on their side as well. If you guys haven't checked out Snack Network, go ahead and check them out. They do a lot of snacks. Never. I'm going to pull a beer out because that other one was about frozen. It's like different days have different things. We're good uploading like 25 videos. Like all at once, or like they're like staged out over like the next few days. That's a lot of video. That's a lot of content. For sure. I've been trying to tune in on some of y'all's live streams on Fridays, but I go live at the same time that you guys are live, sometimes about the same time. It's always day. The one and only. We're coming up on 1,300 subs. We're 20 away now. Getting really close, you know, to hitting 15. Just kind of pushing along, you know, doing our thing. You guys have been amazing. All the donations, all the likes, comments, love has been tremendous. How close are y'all to getting your partnership? Okay. I see the to schedule for the next few weeks. See, I wish I see you guys. I asked the question. Look, like y'all were getting really close to that halfway point of that 1K. And it's huge. It's huge. You know, getting that first like halfway to 1K was like a big thing for me. I think it was just so huge. Moving along, like whenever I seen 500 pop up and populate, it was just gnarly. It was a huge motivation boost to continue doing it and everything else like that. So I hope it's the same for y'all. Y'all make really great videos and great content. To the schedule for the next few weeks though, like I can't do it. I don't know how you guys do it. Y'all do it better than I don't know. But I struggle with doing that. I can't pre-make videos to save my life. On my days off, I just feel so lazy and want to relax and stuff. But then again, like if I was to make 25 uploads, if I was to make 25 uploads for the next few weeks on one day, I'd be trashed. So, 4:30-ish. Gnarly. My biggest thing was like, I don't know, like it was just hard. snowed can do it together.
Yeah.
That's the good thing, too, about, like, snacks. And I talk about it a lot on here, too, as far as it being a review channel, is being an openly known review channel in general. And, like, you guys, you're called the Snack Network, so you do reviews on snacks and drinks and everything, right? The limit to review videos is limitless, because there's always a new item coming out, there's always a new drink, there's always new food. Even if it's not new, it's something that you haven't made a video about. And that's the cool thing about doing drink reviews and alcohol reviews, is there's so many varieties of mixes and cocktails and drinks alone, where the door is open to content, where you can just flood that stuff in and just literally pour it all out. And all it's going to take is that one video that you put out there, and somebody's going to click on it, and then a bunch of people's going to click on it, and then that bunch more is going to click on it, and that's all it takes. Yeah, it's really all it takes. Never ending, it's awesome. Exactly. And that's what's really, really gnarly about it. And the cool thing, too, is, like, even if you can't buy the snacks, you know, you can make review videos of you making the snacks to eat. Like, if it's peanut butter cookies, and y'all go into the kitchen, and y'all make y'all a video of you making the cookies and then trying the cookies. You know, there's just so many things you can do there. And that's why I'm looking into learning how to make my own beers, you know, making meads, legally stuff that you can do, you know, to an extent. Trying to learn different things to do, and the history behind it is what I really love doing. So, it's just so fun. There's so many endless opportunities, and it's ridiculous. And that's what makes doing videos great. You have something that's really amazing to you, and you want to tell the world about it. Then you'll get something that's absolutely disgusting, and you still want to tell the world about it. Like, my thing, tasting-wise, is, like, sunflower seeds. I think that's my biggest, like, personal thing that I do, is I love trying new sunflower seed flavors. Did you see our cocktail video? I did not. Which cocktail was it? This mouse is absolutely crazy. Bud Light Next review, Duckaroos, Freeze Mix Lemon. We made Pokemon cocktails. Oh, okay. I actually think I seen those on Facebook. It may have been you guys that posted it. And it was a thing where, like, all the Pokemon had different, okay, I see it there. 3 weeks ago. I got it right there. That's gnarly. Yeah, it was 3 weeks ago. That video's doing pretty good, too. I'll give it a check. I'll look at it, though. That looks really interesting. There was so many different cocktails and stuff that was on that page when I started looking at the, like, the Pokemon drinks. That there was, at the same time, was it Pokemon, but it was like some other, I think it was an anime, I can't remember what it was, but it was another set of cocktails flavored and color based off of the corresponding characters. I think it was like Marvel, so like there was a Batman drink, there was a Superman and a Spider-Man, or Marvel and DC, where they were doing a bunch of superhero drinks. I think that's what it actually was. And I thought about doing some of those. that's again, that's one of those things that like it makes making videos that much better. I need to turn that light on behind me. Tweedledee, Tweedledum. I know you guys can't really see what it is, but it says Miller Lite. It would be awesome if you made them. You could review Curtis' Pokemon cocktail. Yeah, for sure. They look good. The colors look gnarly too. I'll have to watch it and see how it goes. Because it says Gen 9. They were Gen 9 themed. I would have to do. I would definitely have to make a first gen Pokemon. I would have to go with first gen. It's what I'm most familiar with, at least anyway. And I can at least pronounce half of the. I can at least pronounce first gen Pokemon name. Some of these new gen Pokemon, man, I need to go back to school to pronounce these things. Half of them don't make no sense. They're like 2,000 Pokemon. That doesn't seem right. This only says there's only 898 Pokemon, but I feel like there's way more. We for sure still need to do a crossover. Yeah, we do. I meant to make a Cheez-Its video for you guys, but got behind. Work was crazy. We're working through inventory and stuff like that right now. I still may make a Cheez-Its video for you guys. And just loop it to you or send it to you, however y'all do it. I'll edit it down and then send it over. 890 is right. I just feel like there's so many more. When I played Pokemon Go, I feel like there was just a ton of Pokemon. Is that what it is on Pokemon Go? I don't want to open up Pokemon Go because if I do, it will send me a notifications every day for all day, like 6 or 7 times. Are you running a mixer right now for the music? At the moment, I am running this. This is what I'm using. Top 500 non-copyright sounds. It is 12 hours long almost. That's what I use. It's really good. I like it. And I have gotten way less copyright claims using this than I did anything else. So this, I may get one copyright like claim throughout the whole 12 hours. So I like it. It's good. Sounds good. Music's good. It's got good vibes to it. I'm sitting here drinking that beer and forgot all about that. Probably one of the better mixes I've found too. I had a friend that was supposed to be making me some sounds and some beats to play in the background for my live streams, but it didn't quite go, I don't think. I don't know. I haven't really heard from him in a while. Or we haven't really talked about music making in a while. I even thought about pay, but who knows, man, who knows. I use it for my intros to my live streams. I know you guys have a Snack Network song, so I mean, I ain't as high class as y'all, but we're at it. If we added you on the Skype call, could we all co-stream on Friday? Do you know how to do that on your end? I should be able to. I could do my setup through, I'll get in the Skype call with you guys, and then I'll screen share the live stream. So, like, I could screen share everything. Well, we'll have to look at it. I'll make sure I get it all set up right. But yeah, I'm down. Let me see here, actually. Hang on. What time are y'all thinking about streaming for Friday? Because this Friday... This Friday, I work 11 to 8 p.m. Eastern Time. But Friday on the 15th, I work 7 to 4. So I probably wouldn't stream on this coming Friday until probably well after 9 o'clock, like 9:30. But now the next, not this Friday, but the next Friday would probably work better. I really love it. I think it's dinner time. Good luck, ma'am. Talk to you later. Good luck. Have fun. Have fun uploading all those videos and editing all those videos. That's crazy. And have a good dinner. I'm sit here. I'm going to drink. I already had my dinner. It is 9 p.m. It's 9 p.m. now here. But shoot me a message on Facebook, man. We'll figure it out. I think you have my regular page and my business page. So, whichever one. I don't reckon it's called like a business page. No, I think I'm more or less like a fan page. Just a Facebook drinking page. I don't know what to call it at this point. I need to keep buying bottles for this infinity bottle. So we might get a bourbon or something tomorrow for tomorrow's review. We'll see. When's my next payday? I always get confused on my pay. I never look at like my pay or anything. I never know like my pay. Then we got paid last week. Oh, this check's gonna be bigger too, because I got a whole shit. Right. Let's go. we'll figure it out. I don't want to do it. I kind of want to start. So I got like a portion of my shit goes to the 401k. Everything else goes to taxes. But if I get. I gotta do some math real quick in my head. I was just trying to math some skills, you know. Skills I ain't got. So as usual, guys, you know what this is for and what it's about. This is for everyone who does sub between now and the next live video. We're not ending it right now. But I wanted to take this shot before I drank my Miller because I'm not a huge fan of chocolate. So I kind of wanted to have something to kind of hush it down. So, cheers. I don't know about anybody else growing up, but I grew up in the 90s, and I'm about positive my life and brain cells was killed by White Rain. If you know, you know. Okay? If you know, you know.
On the rise now. Woo! Endless celebrations all in my house. Yeah. Levitating now, I'm super duper fly now. Yeah. Let them boy, but these things are outside now. Put the time in while you always yelling time out. And for critic, cause I know I'm coming with it. You were sitting, you were wishing I was handling my business. Yeah. Now I got the ball like Harry Potter playing Quidditch. And my business is humongous. You were thinking that happens in there. Damn, man, I'm all that. Yeah, I'm all that. Working for that whip. Yeah, that what you call that. I'ma blow up in the summer, have him yelling fall back. And I've always been ahead.
Oh, let's check on the Carolina game. I completely forgot about that.
Yeah.
starts at 9:20. Guys, if you're watching, I would stream it, but we'd probably get in a lot of trouble. But 9:20 p.m. they tip off. UNC number 8, Kansas number 1. UNC at 29-9, Kansas at 33-6. I guess that means UNC had one less game. 29-9 means they had 38 games. Kansas had 39 games. Yeah. News. I got a friend that's at the game right now. He was live. All I said was we are here. That's weird that he got one. Hang on. I see the comments so far away. Hey, bro, what's up? Shine shot? All right, give me 1 second, Frankie. I got you. I'll give you a shine shot. I'll hook you up. I don't know why it wasn't pulling up my comments. I had to refresh it. All right, Frankie. I'm not mistaken. You had me do a shine shot before. You don't have to, like, I'm gonna have to start charging people for shine shots. Shine, one, isn't that easy to find. Good. And, so strong. So strong. Don't let your eyes fool you, trust me. This is not for old Smokey Cherry. I don't think any part of this looks like cherries. Frankie said, I thought you hated me. No, never. Why would I hate you, Frankie? Mother of fuck. Mother of whores. Thank you. on my kind of hernia getting that open. Bag it in. Bag in, son. Look, you can see how like, that shit fucked my hand up. This is some apple pie I got from where I used to live. Back in the day. So, cheers, Frankie. Shine, shine. A little bit more on the warm side. If you're gonna love your country, you're gonna have to love your moonshine. I love enough of my country where I even have it tattooed on my forearm. I got the American flag on my forearm. Live, love, fight, die. I got an American flag here. 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 And there's nothing over there. Nothing over there. Nothing over there. I got enough American flag here. Where it'd be alright. You know what, Frankie? We'll drink another beer just for you, though. Just for you. And,
hell yeah.
Hell yeah, Ricky Bubba. I know you can't really see it from over there, but yeah, right there. We're going to throw these cans away. I'll be right back. Went ahead and utilized my first tea break, which I haven't had yet. What other news we got? Distraction is happiness, weirdos. Yeah, they're showing a case in the movie, or the game. That stadium is packed. Frankie says, I need a friend. What you need a friend for? I'll be your friend.
I got friends in low places.
The whiskey rounds and the beer chips. My blues away.
There's nothing where it's,
fucking Woody does. Too, in the Toy Story movie, there's a friend song.
You got a friend.
Friends are great, but friends aren't needed. And that's what a lot of people get confused with. People are there, and people are around, and friends are there, and friends are around. Not everybody's a friend, and not everybody's around. Everybody's been lame, man.
Being lame, man.
I get that. I get it. I used to always hate, like, sitting there and being like, I have ADHD and shit, obviously. And I would always hate, like, I couldn't sit there and just, like, do nothing. And a lot of people would just want to sit there and be, like, lazy, or they wouldn't want to do anything, or they didn't. I can't just do that. I need to be doing something, moving, doing, talking, something. And I can't just sit there and stare at a wall and blankly not do anything. So, I get that. I get it. That's why I'm here. Playing with my tech deck. Drinking beer. Brewskis. There's this other thing called Streamlabs. Or no, not Streamlabs. Something. I don't know what the piss name of it is. StreamYard. I might start trying to use. I try and people ignore me because I have mental health issues. And then you don't need those people. 100%. You don't need those people. If you're having issues or you're doing something and something's happening, and then they ignore you because of said actions and said things are happening, and you don't need them. They ain't friends. You don't need them. But I want to start this thing called StreamYard, where if I'm live, people can join in and chat also. I think it'll be fun. Maybe instead of like finish on Friday, I do a StreamYard thing. Oh, that would yeet it out of here. You don't need nobody that puts you down. Ever. I don't care if it's somebody that's in your family, your mother, your brother, your sister, your daddy, your uncle, your cousin, your sister. I don't care what it is. If they're putting you down or they're doing some dumb shit behind your back to use, abuse, or miscalculate yourself, fuck. You don't need it. Made mistakes, and it's all about them. What they accuse people of. Exactly. People make mistakes, things happen. Granted, in the grand scheme of things, making mistakes, you may never live those mistakes down. That's just how life goes. Mistakes are one in few. You can do a trillion things right, but one thing will be lived on in your name forever, and that's what you get. So it's always going to be there, and it's never going to change. People are always going to look at that one thing that you did wrong, no matter who's right, she did right. But you know what you did wrong, you know what you do right, and that's all that matters. Nobody else's opinion should ever matter. It doesn't matter how close they are to you. It doesn't matter about anything. Their opinion should not matter to the point of where your life is changing from who you really are or who you really want to be to conform to them, because that ain't shit. That shit's for the birds. Be you, be yourself, do you, and do yourself. That's all you gotta do. That came out weird and wrong. However you want to look at it. Sometimes I have the urge to snap. I have several others. Yeah, man. That's what I'm here for. Honestly. I don't care if I'm here to piss people off or whatever. And also, it follows me around everywhere. I've owned up to my problems. People run away and make me look worse, like they didn't do shit. Then you don't need them. Fuck. People has their opinions. Life is like a relationship, alright? Everybody has two sides to every story. There's two sides. There's a right, there's a wrong, and there's whatever the fuck in the middle that gets compromised into whatever the actual, like, midway truth is, right? So, you know what you did. You owned up to what you did. And then they still make you look worse. You don't need them people. You shouldn't put yourself into a predicament where you're ever around them people again, you know? Granted, I don't know if they're your friends. I don't know if they're your family. I don't want to know those answers because I don't want to, like, I don't want to feel like the person is pushing you away from them. But I would not deal, personally, I would not deal with somebody that no matter what I did, they would always shun me for it. I wouldn't deal with that shit. I'm a bigger and better man than them. Asked to chill, asked for a job, and to help, and then to be there. I still ride with the Lord, but it had to take me. I understand. 100%. I understand. Things change. Things develop. Things move on. But if these people are always this way, then you don't need that type of, you don't need that type of stuff in your life. It just causes stress, it causes worriness, it causes anxiety. You're like, oh, well, anxiety, I get a lot of anxiety for not ever talking to these people again. Yeah, but anxiety one time for never talking to them again compared to anxiety every time you talk to them. Little nine, yo, how's it going? I have a rum recommendation. What shall it be? I'm listening. As always, what I'm here to do. I'll be here drinking. I ain't had it yet. Good musical loud. Okay, I'll turn it down. That should be better. Hopefully that's a little bit better. Turn the desktop audio all the way down, almost. It's Kroger's brand. It's called Four Freedoms. $7. Smoother than Captain, and feels like it's more of a punch. Maybe it's actually stronger, but I drink around half a bottle of Captain a day, so my input might matter. Screenshot. I'll have to look into it and see. Rum is just very far and few whenever I go to my local place here. They don't have a whole lot of rum. They don't have a big rum selection. But I do have 3 to 4 ABC stores or liquor stores that I can check out. So I'll have to try and find it. Four Freedoms. Gotta have a smoke. I feel that. I don't smoke or nothing, but I drink it. I feel like drinking, smoking, all that fun stuff kind of correlates with each other. I feel you. I feel you there. There's a lot of people that use alcohol to get away. Dax has a new song called Alcohol or something alcohol. Let's see. It's called... Dear Alcohol is the name of it, and it speaks to volumes. It speaks volumes. Tenfold. What's your, is that your favorite rum, though, Lil Nine? What's your favorite rum? I know you say you drink Captain Morgan about every day. Dear Alcohol is a song. Yes, that, man. That is, it's insane. It's a very good song. Very, very good song. there's two sides. Everyone should have love. Everyone should be accepted just because we bros. I wouldn't ever diss people or leave them out. Or hurt people. Just because you're bros with somebody doesn't mean you shouldn't hurt their feelings. And I feel like too many people ignore that shit. Just because you're best friends and just because you're tight and you're bros does not mean you should not be honest and hurt their feelings. It doesn't. Does not mean that. But yeah, I agree, Lil Nine Man. Very good song. Very. And I made a post about the song. I posted it on my business page or on the YouTube page on Facebook. And it's a song to listen to. It doesn't matter how you dealt with it, whether or not it's been alcohol. You can replace alcohol with whatever word you want, dear, whatever. And I feel like that song has a huge impact. Other than like clear rum at bars, I usually only order Captain. Okay. Alright. I like Captain Morgan. There's a lot of people that doesn't like Captain Morgan. I actually done a few weeks ago where I done Captain Morgan mixed drinks like every day. And there's so many people. Wasted on You by Morgan Wallen hits too. It does. I've only heard snippets of it. I haven't heard it all the way through yet. But it is really good. I love listening to music. Music is my getaway. I use music for everything. A lot of people try to use like hardcore stuff, you know. I use just music. 750 milliliters so far this year. Damn. You're a good man? Try to be. Yeah, how'd you try the vanilla coke and rum? Yeah, I remember. And that whole week, man, I got scrutinized, you know? there was a good few people that didn't like Captain Morgan. Put my knee in the deck. I try to be the best version of myself that I can be, by the way. Like, 100%. I'm not different from this compared to work. I treat my employees the same way at work that I do when I talk to you guys. I treat myself the same way every single day, you know. I live by everything that I say, 100%. I want to try Kraken. Kraken's really, really good. Kraken has to be on my top list. But here recently, since I found it towards the Christmas time area, is the coffee version. It is a cold brew Kraken, and man, it is addicting. It is so good. Check out my review. I have a review on Kraken, and I have a review on the coffee Kraken, the cold brew. So check both of those out when you get time. I don't think I have the bottle. I do. It's called Black Roast. It's called Black Roast. I love this stuff. This stuff is freaking amazing. I don't know if I have an original bottle of Kraken. No. No regular bottle of Kraken, but I definitely have that one. You have Snapchat? I do not. I used to use Snapchat a lot in my bio or on my YouTube page. You would find my Snapchat, but I haven't downloaded it in a while. I use Twitter. I use Instagram, Facebook, pretty much all of those. And you can find me on Twitter. Or not Twitter. You can find me on Instagram and Facebook under Justin Hallman. But on Twitter, it's going to be different. But all my links are in my banner on my YouTube page. And you'll, if you go to my banner, you'll see all my like names. And then at the bottom right-hand side of it, you'll see like clickable links. And you can click on those and it'll take you to all my links. You can add me on Snapchat, but I don't know if I'll download it again. Hey, I about to say, I just seen an Instagram thing pop up. I got you right back. There you go. Hit you right back. Yeah, you can message me there. A lot of people either reach out to me through Twitter or through Instagram. So whatever you got, you can hit me through there. I try to respond back as soon as possible. Instagram, I'm a little bit slower with. Just depends. If it's a direct message, I usually respond like right away. But if it's a tag or a post, something like that, then it takes me a little bit longer sometimes for some reason. I don't know. But again, I'm learning this whole new, like, talking to people thing. You only drink Miller on Mondays. Yeah, for the most part, Miller's on Mondays because it's Miller Monday. Because it's my go-to beer. Miller Lite is my absolute go-to beer always. But I've actually been thinking about going towards like several different ones. You got Miller 64, Miller High Life, Miller Genuine Draft. And I thought about trying to like move around through those for like Miller Mondays instead of just doing Miller Lite. But I do drink Miller Lite as regular, you know. I mean, I got 2 18s over here. So it's my usual casual drinking beer, mostly for the price, because I can get a case for $15. It just makes sense that way to me. be right back.
I'm going to work. I'm going to go pee.
Key number two. I broke the seal. So good. But I do like Miller Lite. Miller Lite's one of my more favorite beers in general. Unless I'm just going out. I think Four Freedoms is only available at Kroger's. I could send you a bottle to try. The only downside about that is my area doesn't allow us to send or receive alcohol. To an extent, I mean, there's obviously ways of getting around that, but I don't have a P.O. box set up yet, mostly because I haven't, beer makes me throw up, I'm sorry, that sounds terrible, I feel like a P.O. box, it's not quite worth it yet, I would have to spend $200 to $400 a year on a P.O. box, which I know it doesn't sound like much. I understand that. That's less than $12 a month, or that's more than $12 a month. It's like $12 times $12 is $144. So like, I don't know, like $15 a month, some shit like that, some weird thing. But we'll have to see. I found a couple that are worth the money. I just have to figure out the average size of a package of a bottle would be. Because you got an 11 inches by 11 inches, but some bottles are taller than 11 inches and some are shorter. So, I don't need an 11 inch tall box. I need an 11 inch long box. So, there's another one where it's like 5 by 11 also. So, I'll have to see. I'll have to look into it more and see. Well, that totally makes sense. And yeah, it's just kind of aggravating. It really is. I wish there was a way like, oh, I would just drive everywhere somebody wants me to drink a new drink. I would just drive there. Or fly, you know? It's just kind of annoying. But there are Kroger's in the area near me. What's the closest Kroger? Outside of North Carolina, because I'm about to pause. North Carolina is one of the only places around that have Are you in Virginia, by any chance? What state are you in, Lil Nod? I'm going to say it's either Virginia or Tennessee. Maybe South Carolina. But I doubt it. I see more Virginia than Tennessee. Frankie says, Justin Holman! Hello, Emma. You ain't got to give me your actual. In Kentucky? Okay. So, I'm actually going to be going into Kentucky at the end of May. The last week of May, I'm going to be in Kentucky. I'll pick some up then. Don't let me forget, but in the last week of May, shoot me a message or something. Or I'll shoot you a message. I'll forget. I will forget. So, don't let me forget.
We're gonna get the other side to do the same thing. That'd be cool.
I don't know where I'm going in Kentucky, but I'm going to Kentucky. What video have you been the drunkest filming? It's actually probably one of the ones I have to take down, though. I'm trying to think. I don't know. That's a hard one. I would have to bank it on, like, two. There was one video where it took me, the video wouldn't work. I actually still haven't uploaded it because it never worked. I have to take it down because the portion of the video that I uploaded wasn't even the right one that uploaded. It was still a bad version. I drank over a half a bottle of Gentleman Jack trying to make one upload. That was probably one of the worst ones. Some of my more recent ones are really good too. Is like the one I posted yesterday. You could tell that we'd been drinking. There's another live stream in December. I can't remember when it was, but there was a bunch of us on the live stream. There was one, two. It was me. There was like four or five of us in the live stream, and that one was interesting too. The one that we did that I uploaded yesterday, we had already been drinking like two to three hours before that. Before we even started that one. So that one's definitely interesting. The one with the Gentleman Jack, it wouldn't upload properly. It was like, the quality was terrible. So I had to keep remaking the video. And they never worked out. The audio quality was terrible. That one and our Pink Lemonade New Amsterdam did the same thing. I'll probably delete both of those and remake them. Yeah, yesterday's, I'd have to say yesterday's or the one with all of us in December was probably my more drunk dream. I try not to be like too drunk on my videos because I need to control myself And mostly I need to be able to control those who are around me. I think that's the biggest problem. I don't know, Frankie. Can't keep taking shine shots. I'm gonna have to start I have to start charging for shine shots. Somebody somewhere is gonna have to start sending me $5 a shot for shine shots. Cash App, PayPal. Let me know. It'll pop up. It'll pop up when you donate. If I was here and do shine shots all night, I'd be fucked. I'd be blitzed. What is that? Jargon for shine shots? Jargon, Martin. Bro, get the moment until I get my disability. I'll send you something. Man, you ain't gotta send me nothing. Don't think you ain't gotta send me nothing. Don't even worry about that. You ain't gonna send me nada. I ain't here for the money. Granted, I love the donations. It helps a ton. But I ain't here for the money. I ain't here for that. I know when I started this, I wasn't here to get rich. I may get rich from it. But I didn't expect to. Don't expect to. And 100%. Wouldn't ask you to send me a donation from your disability check. You need that more than I do. Y'all, in general, need y'all's money more than I do. Unless you just decide. Last one, though. Anybody else wants a shine shot? It's $5 a shot. Oh, weird. There was a notification that disappeared. Ugh. For Frankie. I think the only thing that makes it a little bit easier is how cold it is. Other than that, it wouldn't be as easy. not even on that channel. Frankie says, yo. Yo.
Yoshino.
Or is it Roshino? I don't know. It's only 10 o'clock. We'll probably hit that 2 hour mark and drop it. So I gotta at least stay up till 11.
Birthday.
It's almost birthday. Interesting.
Drama.
Cheers. Good for your soul, good for your blood. Oh, man, my eyes water almost, though. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. You guys were absolutely amazing. And I cannot wait to see you guys again for some more live streams. Catching you guys on Wednesday with our vampire video game stream. It's going to be really fun. It's going to be different. Hopefully, we're able to get some time into that game. I get up at 6, so hopefully we're live by like 7. We should get a few hours into it. You guys, y'all are amazing. I can't wait to see you guys then. Y'all have a blessed night, and I'll see you guys tomorrow with another brand new review. Y'all are the best, and I'll see you guys again as soon as.